A Central Florida woman almost got off scot-free until cops find out that she left something behind in her vehicle.
Altamont Springs police say Anna Alvarez was caught putting food into her purse at a public store. She told them it was to feed her family. But then they learned she left a baby behind alone in the car in the parking lot. WESH 2's Michelle Meredith is live at the store where it happened with the latest. Michelle?
Well, police were very surprised. They say when they questioned her, she mentioned her 3-year-old son, she mentioned her business, but never said a word about the 5-month-old baby in her car. According to police, 31-year-old Anna Alvarez walked into the Publix on 434 Friday evening, picked up 2 tomatoes and 3 packages of cheese. Altamont police say a loss prevention employee watched Alvarez pay for the tomatoes, but not the cheese. Report says she slipped that into her purse. Police were called.
Officers got on scene, very compassionate to the situation, started talking to the suspect. She advised she stole the 3 packages of cheese for her 3-year-old, who was hungry.
Where was her 3-year-old son? With grandma, Anna told police. Publix decided not to prosecute Anna Alvarez for shoplifting. We're in the process of making it illegal for her to return to the store again when police say she dropped the bombshell.
Officers were escorting her outside. At that time, she announced that for the last couple hours, she had left her 5-month-old unattended in the car.
The report says, sure enough, they walk Anna Alvarez back to her vehicle in the parking lot, and police say in the back seat was her 5-month-old baby, screaming, crying. Police say the windows to Anna's car were up, the doors were locked. Anna Alvarez was arrested on charges of child neglect. She's out on a $2,000 bond. We wanted to get Anna's side of the story and discovered she lives in this gated condo community in Maitland. Her baby did not go into DCF custody. Police allowed the baby's father to pick the baby up. Live in Seminole County, Michelle Meredith, WESH 2 News.